So we want to say a few things to address the collegiate era of Brian's life. promise Bonnie, we keep it short.
That's a little bit personal, don't you think, talking about Brian?
Yes, I didn't mean Brian was short. That's a bit of a bald-faced insult, which is also...
We have nothing but time. No more
Brian jokes. What I did want to talk about, though, is from the perspective of two guys that met Brian more than 30 years ago, the one thing that's always, I think, struck both Tim and I, as Tom, his father, said, is that Brian is a very dedicated, loyal guy. And the fact that we're still friends 30 years later and still getting together for events like this is really down to Brian's dedication and loyalty and just general attempts to kind of keep in touch. And those of you that know Brian and that are here today can definitely attest that he is a guy that really does his best to keep in touch with his friends. And it's not always easy as we get older and, you know, we get married and have families and live in different parts of North America. It has to be said that Brian is definitely a very loyal friend, and we all know that about him, and it makes it extra special to be here on a day like today.
And backing up a little bit, I know that Paul and I talked about what we would say tonight, and this morning sitting in my house having coffee and writing things down and scratching them out and writing other things down. And we kind of started with, and Paul skipped one of these, what do we first remember about Brian when we met him? And it's funny that we have these pictures hanging around the barn on posts. If you take a minute to look at that, and this big one up here. That is actually how I first remember Brian. I was a freshman. Let's see, when did he come in? Yeah, so I was a freshman in college, and what we had as members of the team there, we would host high school kids. They would come and stay with us at college. We would show them a good time, and then they chose Dartmouth and come to run and be on our team. And I had another kid from Connecticut, his name was Tom Paskus. He was one of Brian's major rivals, the major rival for Brian in Connecticut. And I was hosting Tom, and another guy on the team was hosting Brian. So I have Tom in my room, and I say, hey, let's go over to the frats, you know, have a good time over there and see who we see. So we're coming down the stairs to the basement of the frat, and what do I see but I see this. This kid from Connecticut shows up in a green suit with that hairdo, and he's down there just working the broom like he's an old pro. He's a high school senior. And I gotta be honest, actually, that's from his sophomore year of college. So. But that's basically what I'll remember saying back in those days. So Paul, what do you want to say?
Well, I guess I want to wrap up by giving my own reminiscence of how I first met Brian. And when I think about how casual this was and how kind of seemingly meaningless it was at the time, the fact that now, almost 35 years later, we're sitting in a big barn in Chester, Vermont with family and friends and all these people that have come together to celebrate Brian, it just seems amazing in one sense that we've actually stayed friends all these years because of this. But on the other hand, it doesn't seem so amazing, and I'll explain in a second. We were on a run our freshman year at Dartmouth, just a random run. We've probably done thousands of them over the years. And I'm jogging along, and a guy pulls up to me and says, hey, my name's Brian, I'm from Connecticut. I hear you're the new guy from Canada. Nice to meet you. And that little tiny moment was the start of a friendship that, as I said, lasted like 35 years, and we've kind of come to this point like all those years later. So. You know, Brian, as you guys know him, like took the initiative, introduced himself, and from then on, we've stayed in touch, and as I mentioned, largely due to Brian's kind of dedication and loyalty.
So wrapping up, I think we've all met and known each other here because of this common great friend of ours, and we're happy to be here, part of the celebration, as I know you are, and it's a celebration of all of us, just get together like this. I mean, we don't do this enough in our lives anymore, so all of us that have been in this, part of this web, he's one of the guys in the web. We're all part of this web, so it's great to see all of you here, having met all of you in one way or another through this connection. So, great job. Thanks, Brian and Bonnie, and happy birthday.
So here's to Brian.